People are going on TikTok for more than funny videos. They're now using it for medical advice.
Researchers at UChicago Medicine released a report on just how much medical misinformation is being spread on the social media site. Rose Dimitriyannis with UChicago joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm surprised any health information on TikTok is accurate.
There's definitely some good information out there.
Well, that's good.
How is it possible that people, I guess the younger generations are going for news, for everything, and is everyone just believing everything they hear or on TikTok? Is that the problem?
I don't think that's necessarily the case, and I think that medical misinformation has always existed.
Mm-hmm.
It's just maybe easier. It's at our fingertips now with TikTok. But what we found is that specifically with the one diagnosis we looked at, which is sinus infection, I don't want to make grand generalizations,
right.
We found that about 50% of those videos were from non-medical influencers, and from those influencers, over half of those were non-factual.
So they're just making stuff up. The other stuff that was interesting was that you said 15% of the videos done by medical people were not true or inaccurate.
Yes. I think that's also important to state so that you shouldn't just, you know, blindly believe a medical professional on the internet either. Everyone has health inaccuracies on the internet.
Give us an example of maybe some silly things that were not accurate and some things that maybe are more dangerous.
Yeah, I think the classic one that we kept on coming running into is that at the time that we were gathering the information, there was something called the garlic challenge, where individuals were placing garlic cloves up their nose to help with sinus infections. That can be seen as a silly challenge where when you take it out, you have mucus production, but that's because of the irritation that's being caused by the garlic.
Yeah.
The thing that is more serious and dangerous about that is that the garlic can get stuck. You might have an issue getting it out. You can get an infection from that. So there's definitely a darker side to some of these trends.
Yeah.
Is this, the videos being watched on TikTok, is that any more dangerous than people Googling information? Is it, what's the difference?
It's a good question. I think that they're all similar. You know, they're all there. People used to just, you know, look on Google and then find a WebMD article and then look that way. I think that just right now, TikTok and other social medias are the main way that people are looking up their health content, and that's why we want it to look. But, you know, like I said, these things have existed.
Yeah, well, the people who make technology have always been ahead of the curve to the people who regulate it and make laws about it. Does there need to be regulation for something like this where people could be using this to hurt themselves, especially after a pandemic?
Mm. I think that something maybe like a warning sign where it says always speak to a medical professional before doing something to your body that pops up on any health related video might be a good first step. But
sure.
And a lot of, when you say influencers, it could be just someone who's broadcasting in their basement next door does it astound you as a medical student that people are just listening to random people about medical advice? Got to infuriate you.
I mean, I think that, you know, people have parasocial relationships. You have your favorite influencer says something online and you believe them. And I think that it just, I want people to come away from this study understanding, you know, don't believe something just because your favorite influencer said something. Do your own research before you do anything to your body. Talk to a medical professional.
And you mentioned WebMD. Do you consider that a good one? And is there another good online thing for people who want to do that?
I think that, you know, Google Scholar, PubMed, look at actual articles to actually look at factual information. And I know that can be more difficult. So that's why I always say before you do something, talk to a medical professional that can give you real information.
Or maybe, you know, maybe you need to start your own TikTok. She's a medical student. Hello.
We can show you some of the moves. I'm not a doctor per se, but.
Oh, I'm embarrassed, Fred. Thank you for coming in. For more information, you can check out uchicagomedicine.org. She's looking at.
Yeah, I know. Our daughter's just changed the channel.
Thank you, Rose. There's all the info on the screen.